Hi, this is Alfauzia Nihar from At Home Tuition. Welcome to our session today. In today's video, we are going to discuss the topic Tricks and Hints to Solve Ratio Proportion Problem. This session will be helpful to analyze the question and identify the clues given and the approach to solve the problems. Here are the tricks to solve ratio proportion problems. Let me start with hint 1. This is the very basic hint. When a fraction a over b is given, it is nothing but the ratio a to b, that is a is to b. One should be familiar with this basic. Now let us move on to hint number 2. Hint number 2, when two ratios are equal, they are said to be in proportion. For example, if a is to b is equal to c is to d, then you can say that a, b, c, d are in proportion. Does this make sense to you? You should know what is meant by proportions whenever you are dealing with ratio proportion problem. Now let's move on to the next hint. Very important hint is cross multiplication rule. Cross product rule in proportion is very important while solving these problems. The product of extremes will be equal to product of means. Let us consider the proportion. So consider this proportion. Extremes are A and D and means are B and C. So as per the cross product rule, we can multiply this as product of extremes is equal to the product of the means. Hope you are clear with this hint. This hint will be very useful while solving the word problems. Let us move on to hint number 4. Hope you might be familiar with inverse ratios. Inverse ratios are nothing but, for example, B is to A is the inverse ratio of A is to B and vice versa. AB is the inverse ratio of B is to A. You can refer the one of my previous video, Types of Ratios, to learn more about inverse ratio. That is, A is to B and B is to A are the two ratios inverse to each other. Hope that makes sense. Hint number 5. Verification of inverse ratios. If two ratios are inverse to each other, then their product must be equal to 1. That is, A is to B and B is to A are the two ratios inverse to each other. Then you can say that A is to B times B is to A. That will be equal to. Let me write the ratios as fractions. Now proceed with the fractional multiplication. Multiply the terms in top row and multiply the terms in bottom row. So you will be getting AB over AB is nothing but 1. Thus the inverse ratio verified. This is how you can verify the inverse ratio. If your question directs you to verify the inverse ratio, you can proceed in this way. Just rewrite them as a fraction and then multiply. You can proceed as we do in the fractional multiplication and simplify and verify your answer. You should be getting 1. Hope that makes sense. Let us move on to hint number 6. If the ratios of two quantities is given, we want to get the original quantities. We have to multiply both the terms of the ratio by some constant, say x. You'll be getting many word problems like this. You'll be given some details of two quantities. There you have to introduce a variable called x to find the unknown variable. Unless until you name the unknown thing as a variable, it will be a difficult job to solve. Once you fix a variable, it will be easier for you to identify the unknown term. Better I take an example and explain you. Please look at this example. The ratio of earrings of two different persons is given. The direct number is not given. So you can assume that the ratio of the first person would be 3x and the ratio of the second person would be 4x. Whenever the number of the quantity is not given in the exact method, you can just assume it as 3x and 4x just by using the given ratio. Hope this hint is helpful. Now let us move on to hint number 7. Ratio problems are always asking us to compare two different ratios. If we want to compare any two ratios, first we have to express the given ratios as fraction. Then we can make them to be like fractions, because when the denominators are not same, we will not be able to do any addition or subtraction. If that is the case, we have to make them like fractions. That is, we have to convert the fractions to have the same denominators. Let me show some examples. Please look at this example. We are supposed to compare the two fractions. 3 is to 5 and 4 is to 7. So first let us write the ratios as fractions. These two fractions do not have the same denominators. So let us make them same. For that, we have to find LCM of the denominators 5 and 7. So what is the product? That is 5 times 7 will give you 35. Am I right? So we have to make each of the denominator as 35. Then the fractions will be, I'm just going to multiply the first fraction by 7 because 5 times 7 only will give you 35. So multiply the same number with both numerator and denominator. So we'll be getting, let me multiply the second fraction by 5 so that the denominators will be same. So the equivalent fractions will be 21 over 35 and 20 over 35. Now compare the numerators 21 and 20. So which one is the greater one? Yes, 21. So the first fraction is greater. So 3 over 5 is greater than 4 over 7. So in ratios you can say that the first ratio 3 is to 5 is greater than 4 is to 7. This hint will be helpful when you're dealing with problems like arrange the ratios in ascending order or descending order. You just have to make the ratios as a fraction and write the equivalent fractions and compare the numerators to arrange them either in ascending or descending. Hope you are clear with this hint. Now hint number 8. This hint will be helpful when two ratios are given and we wanted to find the another ratio, that is P is to Q is to R. Let me show you step by step. First, find the common term in the given ratios P, Q and QR. We have two ratios, P is to Q, Q is to R. The common term among these two is Q. In both the ratios, try to get the same value for Q. After having done the step 1 and step 2, take the values corresponding to P, Q, R in the above ratios and form the ratio P is to Q is to R. These are the three steps to find the PQR when just two ratios are given. You will understand this concept better if I show you an example. Let me take an example. I'm just taking numbers for PQ and QR. Please look at this example question. In the two ratios, we find Q in common. The value corresponding to Q in the first ratio is 3, right? And in the second ratio, the value corresponding to Q is 4. Now let me find the LCM of 3 and 4. The LCM of 3 and 4 is 12. Am I right? So if you first multiply the first ratio by 4 and second by 3, we'll be getting the same value for Q. I'm going to multiply both the numbers by 4. We have found the equivalent ratio for 2 is to 3 by multiplying the terms by 4. Same way, let us multiply the second ratio by 3. Second ratio Q is to R equal to 4 is to 7. Multiply the numbers by 3 to find another equivalent ratio. I'm getting 12 is to. Now please compare the equivalent ratio P is to Q and Q is to R. Just look at the Q values. Both are same. Both are 12. Am I right? We have the same value 12 for Q in both the ratios. Now the values corresponding to PQR. P is 8, Q is 12 and R is 21. Hence the ratio PQR, P is to Q is to R is equal to 8 is to 12 is to 21. Hope that makes sense. Now let's move on to hint number 9. If the ratio of speeds of two vehicles in the ratio A is to B, then time taken ratio of the two vehicles would be B is to A. This hint will be helpful when you're dealing with problem of a distance, speed and time. Let me take an example. For example, the ratio of speeds of two vehicles B 2 is to 3. Then time taken ratio of the two vehicles to cover the same distance would be just 3 is to 2. Hope you are clear with this hint. Okay, now let us move on to hint number 10. If the ratio of speeds of two vehicles in the ratio A is to B, then the distance covered ratio in the same amount of time would also be A is to B. The previous one is for speed and time. And this one is for speed and distance. Let me take an example. Same one like the previous one. The ratio of speeds of two vehicles B, 2 is to 3. Each vehicle is given in 1 hour time. Then the distance covered by two vehicles would be in the ratio 2 is to 3. Hope that makes sense to you. Now next hint is, if A is twice as good as B, then the work completed ratio of A and B in the same amount of time would be 2 is to 1. When you are dealing with the problems like work completed by certain number of people and different type of people, you can use this hint. For example, A is twice as good as B, because the word of twice. A is twice as good as B and each given 1 hour time. Let me write the example on the board. If A completes 2 units of work in 1 hour, then B will complete 1 unit of work in 1 hour. This is the concept. Hope you are clear with this concept. This hint works when you compare the work of two different peoples separately. So when they do it combinedly, what would be the ratio? Let me write the next hint. Let me write an example for this one. A is twice as good as B and each given the same amount of work to complete. If A takes 1 hour to complete the work, then B will take 2 hours to complete the same work. Hope this makes sense to you. You can just compare the previous hint and this one. You'll definitely be getting some problems of this type. If m kg of one kind costing $A per kg is mixed with n kg of another kind costing $B per kg, then the price of the mixture would be just ma plus nb over m plus n per kg. Please make a note down this formula. When you're dealing with cost problem, you can use this formula. One last hint. This hint will be helpful when dealing with quantity increase or decrease. If one quantity increases or decreases in the ratio A is to B, then the new quantity is B of the original quantity over A. That is, you just have to assume some variable for this one. So it will be BX over A. Hope you are clear with all the hints that I have discussed in this session. In case if you get any query, please